Now our device has successfully started up. After starting up, we can configure the device. This so-called device configuration can also be termed device management. For our VRP platform, we typically have two management methods. One is web management, the other is command line management. This web method, some of you may be very familiar with. If we have operated our home wireless router, how do we operate our home wireless router? We connect the wireless router to the computer, right? Then we set the computer's IP to be in the same subnet as the router's IP. Then we can directly access it, right? Usually it's the private address 192.168.1.1. Of course, there are other addresses. So, after entering through this address, we will see a management interface in the web interface. In the browser, there will be a management interface. So, our web management method is similar to this method. Its biggest feature is the graphical interface. If we want to find a function, we can search for it in this interface. And using it is relatively more user-friendly. Here, I see we can access through HTTP and HTTPS methods. So here, we can see we can use HTTP and HTTPS methods to log into the device. Of course, as one of our devices, if you want to configure it, firstly, you definitely need to log in, right? You might need to use a username or a password. Then, for our Huawei ACs or Huawei routers and switches, and other such devices, we have another method. As communication engineers, if we are involved in device maintenance, this command line method is definitely very familiar to us. A black screen, of course. This screen color can be adjusted, or say, the color of the text displayed can also be adjusted. But there's one thing, we can only enter various strings to manage our devices through strings. It's just like those impressive engineers you see on TV. So this command line method is actually the most commonly used by operations engineers. It's simple and fast. So if you want to use the command line method, we can log into the device in a few different ways. The first way is via the console port. If we are setting up a new device, at the first power on, we can use a console cable and connect it via the console port to link this console port with our PC. This way, we can configure the device through the console. Once we've done some initial configurations, after we've made some preliminary settings, how are these preliminary configurations done? They are configured through the console port. After these preliminary configurations, we can also remotely access via Telnet or SSH in this manner to log into and configure the device. SSH and console are the methods we use a bit more frequently. Because the first time we start up, we generally need to use the console to load some scripts. After the scripts are loaded, subsequent remote logins and remote management are usually done using SSH, because SSH is more secure than Telnet. It has better security. These are our two management methods, web and command line. Usually these methods are commonly used, but previously, as traditional network engineers, we would use these methods. We might have used the command line method more often. So, as we mentioned about the first login, we need to use the console to log in. Using the console here is very simple. Connect the serial port of our user terminal, our computer, directly to the device's console port. Then, with specific terminal software, you can access via the console port and start configuring. Here, we also have another method of login called virtual terminal type, virtual type terminal, abbreviated as VTY. This is also a commonly used method. If we use Telnet or S-Telnet, what is S-Telnet? As we mentioned earlier, SSH, in our devices, it's actually called S-Telnet, which is a more secure version of Telnet. So if you log in this way, you would need to use VTY, this login method. Essentially, it means establishing a VTY channel and then accessing the device through this VTY channel. So, how is this channel established? Using Telnet or S-Telnet, this is our method of logging in. Two consoles and VTY for our Huawei devices. Generally speaking, the number of VTYs is usually 15. VTY numbers range from 0 to 14. Later, when I'm doing the experiment, I can demonstrate this for everyone. So, this is our user interface, how to log into our device. As we mentioned earlier, if you want to log into the device, you generally need to provide a username and a user password. That is, when logging into the device, we need to use an identity to log in. This identity is what we call a user. Different users are assigned different user levels and different command levels. What are command levels? It means what level of commands you can use. Higher level commands can perform more extensive operations on the system. Let's take a look. Our user levels range from level 0 to the last up to level 15. The highest level is level 15, and command levels range from level 0 to level 3. This is somewhat different. Let's see. What is level 0? Level 0 is what we call the visitor level. Display. The so-called display is showing configurations. It means we can view some of the configurations on our device, but not all configurations, only some of them. Then, you can use some relatively simple commands, and if you reach level 1, it is the monitoring level. At the monitoring level, what can we do? It can be used for system maintenance, but you can also use many commands. You can use more commands than at the visitor level. Now let's look at levels 0, 1, 2, the highest being 2, called the configuration level. At this level, you can configure the network. Of course, the configuration commands are not to say that all commands can configure. Only some commands can. Why? Because this level is not the highest yet. The final one is our level 3. Level 3 is the highest level, called the management level. At this level, basically, all commands on our device can be used. Usually, our administrators with the highest authority are granted command level 3. This way, all commands can be used. This is our user levels and command levels. Different user levels correspond to different command levels. If it's just a monitoring personnel, usually we will assign visitor level or monitoring level. Of course, if monitoring personnel need to perform some operations, we will assign configuration level, but as our maintenance management personnel, we need level 3, the management level, command level. These are the different levels assigned to different users. Now that we have users assigned with certain levels, we can log into the device and operate. Now let's take a look at how to log in via the web management interface. This method of login is very similar to our routers. Our PC is connected to our AC. Then an IP address can be configured on the AC. Then we can use HTTPS and enter this IP address, press enter. Thus, we can log into our management interface. Very similar to a router. So if we are in the data center and we don't have such conditions, or say we prefer to log in using the command line, then we would need to use a console cable. Take a look. The console cable looks like this. Its interface looks like this. This interface has a total of 9 pins. Then, on the switch or on our device side, we use the RJ45 console. It uses an RJ45 interface. On our PC side, we use a COM port. It's the 9-pin interface. Of course, many PCs today do not provide this COM port. The COM port is quite large and takes up space, and it's not used very often in normal circumstances. If we are not a professional in this field, now we can use a COM to USB adapter cable. Through the adapter cable, we can connect the COM port to our PC. So this is how to use the COM port to connect our PC device. Once connected, we need a user terminal. In this example, we use PuTTY, which is a very useful terminal software. Once we are connected, and once we have confirmed the connection, we can open PuTTY. Let's set up PuTTY. Let's see how to set it up. For this terminal, we need to use serial, which means the serial port. Then select a serial port interface. Here we select COM1. Our computer also has COM2, COM3. You can choose freely. This depends on which port you connect to your device. This is COM1. Then the speed is 9600. Once configured, we can proceed with the connection. Now the second method, as we just mentioned, is using the VTY method to log in. If using the VTY method, Telnet, we can select Telnet here in this PuTTY interface. If we mentioned using sTelnet or SSH, we can choose here. SSH. So, because Telnet and SSH connections use a Layer 4 protocol, that is, we need to specify a port number. This is something everyone should know, because for Telnet and SSH, we need to specify a port number. For SSH, the common port number is 22. If using Telnet, the common port number is 23. And that is how we configure our connections. That is right here, configuring the port number. After configuring, we click this open, and then we can log in. This is the VTY method for how to remotely log in. Assuming our configuration is correct, and our connections are also correct, now we can successfully log into our device to manage it. Let's look at what the interface looks like after a successful login. The interface will look like this. Then, first here, we enter a sys command. This sys command is incomplete. After pressing tab, our system will intelligently complete it to system view. Then hit enter. After hitting enter, we find it tells us enter system view. We've entered the system view. If we want to go back, we can use Ctrl plus Z. Of course, using the quit command also works to return. So let's see, after we enter the system view, the brackets change. Initially it was angle brackets, right? After entering, it has now become square brackets. Generally speaking, once we enter these square brackets, that is, after we've entered the system view, we can then perform some configurations on the device. If we don't enter the system view, the operations we perform are more about displaying the device's configurations. If specific configurations are needed, we generally need to enter the system view. That concludes our first section. What is VRP? VRP is one of our operating systems. Similar to other operating systems, we also have a file system and various different management methods. We have web interface management, and we can also use the command line to enter and manage the operating system. We also talked about users of the operating system, who have different user levels and command levels. User levels range from 0 to 15, and command levels from 0 to 3. This is about our users. Now that we have successfully logged in to our VRP system, we logged into the VRP system through CLI. The next section will introduce how to use the command line interface of the VRP system.